there are two ways to do this. I won't get on today's webinar into the specifics. I welcome you to reach out specifically if you want to really get into the nitty gritty, because I don't think enough people here want to go into coding and stuff today. I will say there are two main ways to do this. One, PHP to create a session variable. This is going to be a little more developer heavy. PHP is obviously going to be some server-side coding and all of that. You can basically set PHP that when a user arrives on your site with your tracking parameters in the URL, it grabs them, stores them in a session variable. That session variable will follow that user for the entire time they're on the website. Or you can use Google Tag Manager. There are several plugins and tutorials out there where you can use GTM to create a session cookie that does the same thing. When they come in, it grabs whatever parameters are in the URL, stores them in a cookie, and then you can set your form up to call to that session variable or cookie and pull those parameters out. There's even a Google Tag Manager way of basically saying every time they click a link to another page on the website, just grab those tracking parameters and put them on the URL when it loads again. That slows the load time down ever so slightly, so I tend to avoid that because we have folks in-house who can script out the more complex way, but there are easier and harder ways of doing this. But at the end of the day, what you need to do is get your tracking parameters into a session variable or cookie and then set up your form to grab them. Because what you'll find, go to any website, any like major company, even your own school might be already doing this for some variables. Look at their lead capture forms. Look at what they're capturing that's visible that you fill out. Then view their page source. Look for how many elements in that form are listed with a value type of hidden. These are the things that your form can pull your tracking parameters from. Now, if you're using a PHP for like a session variable, your developer is going to need to code out some additional PHP for the form post or get to call that variable. I'm going to be candid. I'm speaking on things in the PHP side above my head and pay grade because I'm not a developer by trade. We have someone who does that part. On Google Tag Manager, there are easier ways to call the variables from a session cookie. So that's the way I tend to default a little bit. But at the end of the day, what you need your form to do is pass those parameters as hidden values. Because when you do that, you're going to have fields in your CRM ready to grab those. So you can do it one of two ways. If it's a brand new parameter that you want to track, create a custom field in the CRM for it. Go into Salesforce and create a custom field that's called paid search keyword or ad position. Or you can just map the incoming variable. You can say, you know what, I want source ID to map in my existing Salesforce field to the traffic source field that's already there. If you don't want to create new fields on your CRM entries, you can just map the incoming data to a new one. If you're not in charge of your Salesforce, if you're not in charge of your CRM, your admin would be able to do this because they've already set up your lead capture initially. Somehow or another, someone has already set up that your program selection or your first name and last name on the application are going to map to some field in your CRM. So they're the ones to turn to help map the additional parameters in. You're just sending more information in there. Now, when you do that, you're only part way to our total solution that we want to get to, but already you're going to be able to pull some neat reports from your CRM. Already, you're going to be able to start looking and seeing which channels as a last touch point. Keep this in mind. This is still just on the last touch point attribution. What were the final channels, final keywords, ad position, et cetera, whatever those parameters are that generated entries in my CRM? And then you can start looking downstream and pull reports. Say if you're in HubSpot, pull a deal stages report and say, which channels that produced leads or applicants for me ended up turning into enrollments or interviews or students at a better rate. That's a great first step. If you're not doing that yet, you're already a good step forward, but you're still on last touch point attribution, because all we have just set up is take whatever the last thing that got someone to your website is and whatever parameters are on that, put them in when you create the new entry in your CRM. So that actually doesn't solve the attribution piece for us. It gives you a little better idea of which final touch points are converting lead to student at a better rate, and gives you a little better idea maybe of some of the costs associated. What we really want to be able to see is if there were 10 paid search keywords that drove me to your website over a period of 30 days, which ones played what role in me eventually becoming a student? Did all of them? When did they occur? And we want to see that across everything.